गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, वेलकम टू क्लास थर्ड. दिस इज़ योर इंग्लिश सेकेंड, दैट इज़ लिटरेचर क्लास. योर बुक नेम इज़ मलबरी. आई एम हर्षिका केन एंड आई एम योर इंग्लिश टीचर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस जर्नी विद फर्स्ट चैप्टर, गोइंग टू द फेयर. As you all might not be having mulberry books, so here are the pages of chapter 1 of your book. Firstly, we will be reading the chapter line by line, and after that explanation will be done. So let's start now. As you can see, the chapter begins with a small exercise which you need not do in your notebooks. Kindly note the answers of this exercise somewhere so that you can fill them once you get the books. Come, let's discuss. As you can see, four pictures are given here. Related to those pictures, few words are listed there. What you have to do? You have to look at those words and think where you would be looking these things, or you have to write the name of a place where you will find these things, like pots and pans, a stove, a waste bin, a sink. Think where you will find all these words or all these things. Yes, you find these things in a kitchen. So the answer is a kitchen. Come to the next one. Cakes and pastries, bread, biscuits, ovens. Now think where you will find these things. Yes, you find these things in a bakery. So the answer is a bakery. Third one, cows, goats, hens, fields, a well, a fence. Now think where you will find these things. Yes, you find these things in a farm. So the answer is a farm. Last one, food and craft stalls, a Ferris wheel, music, games, crowds. So where you will find all these things? Yes, you find all these things in a fair. So, come begin the chapter. Fern and her brother, Avery, live on a farm with their parents, Mrs. and Mr. Arable. Both Fern and Avery are very fond of the animals they raise on the farm. One day, Fern and Avery visit the fair with their parents. Let's read about their day. The night before the fair, everybody went to bed early. Avery lay dreaming that the Ferris wheel had stopped and that he was in the top car. Fern lay dreaming that she was on the swings. When they pulled into the fairgrounds, the next morning, they could hear the music and see the Ferris wheel turning in the sky. So, a meaning is given here at the bottom of the book. First is Ferris wheel. The meaning of Ferris wheel is a large wheel ride at a fair which has seats on its edges for people to ride in. And second word is fairgrounds. It means fields or open areas where fairs are held. They could smell the dust and they could smell burgers frying. They could see balloons aloft. They could hear flocks of sheep bleating in their pens. Bleating means crying sound of a sheep or goat. "Can I have some money?" asked Fern. can I too? Asked Avery. I'm going to win a doll by spinning a wheel and it will stop by the right number, said Fawn. I'm going to steer a jet plane and bump it into another one, said Avery. Can I buy a balloon? Asked Fawn. Can I buy frozen custard, a cheeseburger, and a balloon? Asked Avery. You children, be quiet till we get the animals unloaded, said Mrs. Arable. Let the children go off by themselves, suggested Mr. Arable. The fair only comes once a year. Mr. Arable gave Fawn and Avery some pocket money. Now run along, he said. And remember, the money has to last all day. Don't spend it all in the first few minutes. Be back here at the truck at noontime so we can all have lunch together. And don't eat a lot of stuff that's going to make you sick to your stomachs. And if you go in those swings, said Mrs. Arable, you hang on tight. You hang on very tight. Hear me? Don't get dirty. And don't get overheated, said their mother. Students, overheated means too hot. Watch out for pickpockets, warned their father. Now, pickpockets means people who steal money from others' pockets. The children grabbed each other by the hand and danced off in the direction of the merry-go-round toward the wonderful music and the wonderful adventure and the wonderful excitement. Mrs. Arable stood quietly and watched them go. Then she sighed. Then she blew her nose. Do you really think it's all right? She asked. Well, they have got to grow up sometime, said Mr. Arable. And the fair is a good place to start, I guess. As you have read the chapter, now we will be having the explanation of the chapter in brief, or we can say that we will be discussing what the chapter was about in a brief manner. Students, as we have finished reading the chapter, we understood that the chapter is focused on two children, Fawn and her brother Avery, and their visit to a fair with their parents. Their parents are Mrs. and Mr. Arable. The night before the fair, everybody went to bed early. Avery dreamt that the Ferris wheel had stopped and that he was in the top car. Fawn dreamt that she was on the swings. Students, as you can see, the picture is given here. The Ferris wheel looks similar to this picture. Next day, when they visited the fair, they could hear the music and see the Ferris wheel turning in the sky. They could smell the dust and burgers frying, could see balloons aloft, and could hear flocks of sheep bleating in their pens. Flocks of sheep bleating means they could hear the sound, the crying sound of the sheep bleating in their pens. Mrs. and Mr. Arable were unloading the animals for the show in the fair. So unloading the animals means they were removing the animals or taking out the animals from their vehicle. They were doing so because they were going to perform a show in the fair, and for that purpose they brought the animals in the fair. Both the children asked for some pocket money to their parents as they wanted to enjoy there. Fawn wanted to win a doll by spinning and buy a balloon. Avery wanted to steer a jet plane by frozen custard, a cheeseburger, and a balloon. Mrs. and Mr. Arable gave them some money along with some instructions like don't eat a lot of stuff, hang tight on swings, don't get dirty and overheated, and to beware of pickpockets. So these were some warnings given to them after giving them pocket money. The children grabbed hands together and ran off to enjoy. Mrs. Arable was little worried about them, but Mr. Arable wanted them to see grow up. So he was not in tension, and as according to him, the fair was a good place for it. Now, after the explanation of the chapter, we will try to solve the exercises given in the book. So let's start now. So students, we will start with the word meanings, and along with other exercises, you have to do these word meanings also in your copies. So first one, Ferris wheel. A large wheel ride at a fair which has seats on its edges for people to ride in. Second, bleating. It is the crying sound of a sheep or goat. Third, overheated. Overheated means too hot. Fourth, pickpockets. It means people who steal money from others' pockets. Now, we will start our exercises. We will start it with our first section, that is making connections. First one, complete the following sentences. Two incomplete sentences are given to you and you have to complete them with regard to what you have read in the chapter. So, let's start now. First, Avery dreamed dash. So, just try to recall, what did Avery dream? Avery dreamed that the Ferris wheel had stopped and he was in the top car. B. Fern dreamed dash. Now try to recall, what did Fern dream? Fern dreamed that she was on swings. Now second exercise, draw up two lists. One showing how Fawn planned to spend her money and the other showing that Avery wanted to do with the money he had. As we have studied in the chapter that both the children asked for some pocket money to their parents. They wanted to do something with that money. Now you have to prepare two lists, one for the Fawn and second for the Avery, and you have to list all those things what they wanted to do with that money. So the answer is, for the Fawn's list, it is she wanted to go on the swings, win a doll and buy a balloon. Now for Avery, we can list that he wanted to ride the Ferris wheel, steer a jet plane, eat a frozen custard and a cheeseburger, and last, buy a balloon. Our second section is word wall. Its first exercise is write the correct collective noun. A collective noun is the word used to represent a group of people, animals, or things. So in this exercise, you have to fill a proper collective noun for these group of animals, persons, or things. First one, an dash of ants. So a group of ants is known as army. So the answer is army. B, a dash of sheep. A group of sheep is known as flock. So the answer is flock. Third, a dash of people. A group of people is known as crowd. So the answer is crowd. D, a dash of students. A group of students is known as class. So the answer is class. E, a dash of penguins. A group of penguins is known as colony. So the answer is colony. F, a dash of grapes. A group of grapes is known as bunch. So the answer is bunch. And G, a dash of fish. A group of fish is known as school. So the answer is school. Second exercise. In the sentences given below, underline the collective nouns. Put a tick against the sentences that are correct and a cross against those that are wrong. So what you have to do in this exercise is that few sentences are given below and you have to underline a collective noun in those sentences. After that, you have to see whether that collective noun stands correct for that particular group of thing or not. If it stands correct for that particular group of thing, you have to put a tick after the sentence. Otherwise, you have to put a cross after the sentence. So let's start with question A. The herd of sheep is in the field. In this sentence, collective noun is herd, and see if it is correct or not. Collective noun for group of sheep is not herd. It is flock. So the sentence is wrong. B, the bunch of flowers are in the vase. So the collective noun is bunch, and the collective noun for group of flowers is bunch. So the sentence is correct. Third, the team of oxen are pulling the cart. The collective noun is team, and the collective noun for group of ox is also team. So the sentence is correct. D, the fleet of ships is sailing today. The collective noun is fleet here in this sentence, and also the collective noun for group of ships is also fleet. So the sentence is correct. E, this band of musicians play very well. The collective noun in this sentence is band, and a group of musicians is also known as band. So the sentence is correct. F, a swarm of bees make honey. The collective noun in this sentence is swarm, and also a group of bees is known as swarm. So the sentence is correct. Third section is grammar time. Its first exercise is match the feminine gender words with the masculine gender words. On the left hand side, you can see few feminine gender words listed here. On the right hand side, you can see few masculine gender words. You have to match these feminine gender words with their respective masculine gender words. So let's start. A, headmistress. The answer is headmaster. B, nun. The answer is monk. C, wife. The answer is husband. D, niece. The answer is nephew. E, aunt. The answer is uncle. Second exercise. Sort the gender of the words given below and put them on the correct list. Students, in the book, you will find that in this exercise, few words will be given to you and you have to arrange those words in their appropriate columns. Three columns are given: one, masculine; second, feminine; and third, common. Words that denotes a male person or an animal will be written under masculine category. Words which denotes a female person or an animal will be written under feminine category. And words which denotes both male and female person or animal will be written under common column. So, here we have already sorted all these words according to their category. Answer is, under masculine category, we have these words: policeman, groom, watchman, wizard, grandson. Under feminine category, we have the following words: bride, policewoman, lady, queen, sister. Third one, common category. We have these words in this column: doctor, friend, student, child, and teacher. Fourth section is punctuation. Punctuation is the use of special symbols that you add to writing to separate phrases and sentences to make the meaning of the sentence more clear. One of the most commonly used punctuation is comma. The comma is used to separate parts of a sentence, and if the sentence is spoken, the comma generally indicates a short pause. In this exercise, we have already placed the comma at the right place. Just notice the use of comma in these sentences. First, Rohit, Nina, Soma, and Mona study at the same school. Second, in the classroom, there are desks, chairs, and cupboard. Third, Diwali, Pongal, Dashera, Navroz, and Eid are all festivals. Fourth, Joel went to the market and bought some beans, 6 bananas, a book, and a pencil. Fifth, I like reading, watching films, listening music, and playing football. Next is reference to context. In this, a line from the chapter will be given, and related to that line, few questions will be given. You have to answer them. So, let us start now. The line is, "You children, be quiet till we get animals unloaded," said Mrs. Arable. Related to this statement, there are three questions which you have to answer. So, first question is, who were the children that Mrs. Arable was speaking to? Now, students, you just try to recall what were the names of the two children. The answer is, Mrs. Arable was speaking to Avery and Fern. Second question, where were the Arables? Why were they there? Now, try to recall where the Arables went and for what purpose. The answer is, the Arables were in the fair to see their animals. Third, why did Mrs. Arable ask the children to be quiet? The answer is, she asked the children to be quiet because they were unloading the animals. The next statement is, watch out for pickpockets, warned their father. The first question related to this extract is, Why did Mr. and Mrs. Arable give instruction to their children? Students, when we read the chapter, we read that the two children asked for some pocket money to their parents. Their parents gave equal money to each of them along with some warnings. So, why were these warnings given? Or, if we want someone, why do we do so? Students, when we want someone, we are making them safe and responsible. So, the answer is, they gave instructions to their children to make them safe and responsible. Now, second question. List two other warnings that they gave to the children. We read that the children were given many warnings by their parents. So, we have to write only two of them. So, the answer is, don't get dirty and don't get overheated. Now, last question related to this extract. Which word in the extract means people who steal purses and wallets? Students, here you have to find out a word from the extract given above which is similar to the meaning of people who steal purses and wallets. So, the answer is pickpockets. Next is read, reflect and write. These are also questions and answers, and we will start with question number 5. What were the sounds that Fern and Avery heard when they reached the fair? Students, we read in the chapter that when the children reached the fairground, they heard several sounds, like they heard the sound of the wonderful music and the burgers frying. Even they heard the sound of crying noise of the sheep. So the answer to this question is, when they reached the fair, they heard the flock of sheep bleating and the wonderful music. Sixth question. How did the parents feel about the children going off on their own? How did the children feel about going off on their own? This question means that you have to write the feeling of the parents, what they felt when the children went alone or by their own to enjoy. And you have to write the feeling of the children also, that how they felt when they went alone or by their own to enjoy. The answer to this question is, Mrs. Arable was worried about children, but Mr. Arable wanted them to see grow up. So, he was not in tension. The children felt merry and excited about going off on their own. The last question, question number 7 is, do you agree with Mr. Arable that the fair is a good place to start growing up? Write two reasons for your answer. Well, the answer to this question is, yes, I agree with Mr. Arable because it gives exposure to understand people and to use the money properly. Last section is write well. This is the composition section in which you have to compose a paragraph on the given topic. The topic is the fair. Few words are also given for help which you can use to compose a paragraph. Hence, a paragraph is composed using these words like, I like a fair which is exciting and wonderful. It is held on an enormous ground outside the village every year on Baisakhi. The fair was crowded. A bazaar was set up with mouth-watering or delicious food items. There were many adventurous games and swings to ride, which were sometimes dizzying. The most colorful event of the evening was the Bhangra dance. We were also warned by the announcers many times to keep our money and things safe. In the evening, we left for home with others. Now, students, as we have completed the explanation and exercises of the chapter, so here's your homework. You have to read the chapter again and learn the word meanings. Also, you have to write the word meanings, exercises, and all the question answers in your notebooks neatly and systematically. We will meet in the next class. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.